So what happened in the treatment of AML over the last 5 years? Many things. Many new drugs have been approved by the FDA. No less than 8 new drugs have been approved over the last 2 years, which is unprecedented. So the treatment of our patient has changed. First, for the patients who are fit for the chemo, to receive intensive chemotherapy. For these patients, what we have seen is the introduction of targeted therapies like FLT3 inhibitors, midostaurin, for example, which has been approved in this indication in association with the conventional 3+7 chemotherapy. New FLT3 inhibitors are currently being evaluated in the same context, like gilteritinib, for example, but also quizartinib. And also the IDH1 and 2 inhibitors are also currently being evaluated in combination with the intensive chemotherapy. So what we are expecting from these new drugs to increase the response rate of the patients and increase the quality of response. And the other important new thing to evaluate this quality of response is the evaluation of minimal residual disease. MRD can be now be assessed using flow cytometry. It is widely used today. We still need to learn more regarding the potential of this new technology. In addition to flow cytometry, we can now measure minimal residual disease using next generation sequencing. And probably, as it has been recently reported, the combination of the two techniques may improve the potential to discriminate the patients who will relapse and those who may be cured by the conventional treatment. So this is two major advances. And we also have seen advances for the treatment of the patients who are unfit for the intensive treatment with the appearance of probably a new standard of treatment, which is venetoclax plus azacitidine. So now we have to move forward. We just wait for the confirmation of the superiority of venetoclax and azacitidine, and this will be done in the coming months with the analysis of large prospective phase 3 trials. Once this will be done, we will have to work on a new combination, the addition of new drugs in triplets on the top of this doublet of Ven-Aza. And what has been also reported at this ASH meeting is the evaluation of novel combination, such as, for example, the combination of venetoclax and idazanatline, which has shown a promising response rate in a phase 1 trial. So we have a lot to do for the next, for the coming years, and we need to set up large trials because we are splitting our patient population in many subgroups based on the genetics characterization of the leukemia. And to do that, we have to build up a large intergroup consortium.